Hello, this is Paul from Fosatec. In this lecture, I'm going to introduce limits at infinity. This limit at infinity is different from the limit of infinity we discussed before. Okay, at infinity, which means when x approaches infinity, later you will see. Okay, and I was going to give you the definition first. And then I will introduce how to use the table. Okay, so to list the value of the function, look at the pattern from the table to find what is the limit. So first, what's the intuitive definition? Later, I will give you the precise definition. As abstractional data language we learned before. Okay, similar with that. So the intuitive definition is this. What is limit at infinity? Which means that when x approaches infinity, see the value of the function will approach L. So we say, is this the limit of f as x approaches infinity is L. Okay. What does this mean? Intuitive means if the value of f can be made arbitrarily close to L by taking x to be sufficiently large. This time is not x approach to a number a, but x approach infinity. Approach infinity, which means x to be sufficiently large. Okay, gets larger when x gets larger and larger, and that the value of the function gets closer and closer to L. And then we define L is the limit at infinity. Look at the graph. So this graph exactly tell us if we have a function, and then if we draw horizontal line y equals L, can you see when x gets bigger and bigger, the value of the function approach L, or the graph of the function close to L, right? Okay, it gets closer and closer to L, or we say it's arbitrarily close to L by taking x to be sufficiently large. Okay. By taking x to be sufficiently large, the value of the function gets arbitrarily close to L, which means the limit is L. Okay, the same is this. If a function goes down and also approaches to L, that's therefore when x, of course, when x goes to infinity, so the limit at infinity is L. Okay, these two is the similar. Let me look at another. So we call the intuitive definition of a limit is dia at infinity. But this time I will look at what? I will look at the left side, okay? Infinity, negative infinity. We look at a negative infinity. What does the limit of f as x approaches negative infinity is L. Okay, it's still similar, okay? And we say this, the value of f can be made arbitrarily close to L. Okay, by taking x to be sufficiently large, but negative. Okay, all the graph look like this. If our functions go down to L at a negative infinity, which means that when x gets a big, not large negative, keep in mind that. Okay, when x approaches negative infinity, the value of the function approaches L, which means L is a limit at infinity. Okay, at a negative infinity this time. So if you like, you can put at a negative infinity. However, it's just at the limit at the infinity. Okay. Here is the same. See the left side, and the value of the function approach L, which means that the limit at infinity, negative infinity is L. Okay, this is the same. And the limit at negative infinity, which means look at the left side, left end. Okay, you say is the left tail. If you look at the right tail, we call the limit at infinity. The intuitive definition is very similar as normal limit that we learned before. Very similar. So now, I will give you the precise definition. Precise definition. Exactly, this is more important. Okay, if we have a theorem in the future or a good result, how to prove? Intuitive definition never gives a proof. Okay, abstractional data language, or here is not abstractional data, is we call the precise definition, and it can give us a strict proof in the future. Okay, so pay attention to this language. So how to strictly say the limit of f at infinity is L is this. Let me look at the graph first. And we look at infinity, which means the right tail, which means what? We take x sufficient to the large, the value of the function gets closer and closer to L. If we draw L is a horizontal line, what does arbitrarily close? Do you remember? If we pick any epsilon greater than zero, no matter how small is epsilon. So which means what? We have an epsilon neighborhood of L. And if the value of the function go into the epsilon neighborhood of L, which means L gets closer, arbitrarily closer to L, right? Okay, so this time it is. We take epsilon. So we have L minus epsilon and plus epsilon. So we draw two horizontal lines, we get the bend. Can we look at it? The right tail, the function will definitely go into the bend. Okay, by taking x sufficiently large. Taking x sufficient to be sufficiently large, which means we can find a number n. Okay, when x is greater than n, which means go to the right tail. When x goes the right tail or the right side of n, the graph of the function go into the bend, or the value of the function go into the epsilon neighborhood of L, which means what? Which means this is the precise definition, very similar as the epsilon delta definition for normal limit. Okay, so we look at it one more time. Is this for every epsilon, no matter how small, for every epsilon greater than zero, we can find n greater than zero, such that if x is greater than n, right, the right size, which means x is large. When x is large, then see what does this mean? This means f go into the epsilon neighborhood of L, which means f is close, arbitrarily close to L, right? If x is large enough, and then f will go into the neighborhood, epsilon neighborhood, which means f close to L. X is larger, f close to L. That's the limit, is L, right? Okay, so it's similar. How to prove? Given epsilon, we need to find the n. If x is greater than n, fx is going to the epsilon neighborhood. If you find n, this statement is true. That's a proof. Okay. This is one. We have another, which means the limit at a negative infinity. Okay, we look at the left end point, the left tail. I'm going to see it's just here. It's similar. Okay. This time we not look at the right tail. Look at the left tail. Right? Do you know? Okay, when x is a large negative, is going to the negative infinity, be sufficient to the large negative. Remember, when we take x be sufficient to the large negative, the value of alpha will get closer, arbitrarily closer to L. So they are the same. We use epsilon neighborhood. Okay, which means given no matter how small epsilon is, okay, this is a band. Okay, given epsilon, we can find n. Of course, this time you say n should be a negative number, no matter how big the negative number is, right? Okay, no matter how far, okay, to the left side is, we need to find the n. When x is less than n, which means go to the left tail of n, see, and the value of the function or the curve of the function go into the bend, which means that the value of the function go into the epsilon neighborhood of L. So they are the same, which means what? When x is large negative enough, and then f arbitrarily close to L. Therefore, that's the precise definition. All we need to do is give epsilon neighborhood of L, we can need to find n. And then when x is less than n, okay, all the graph will go into the neighborhood of epsilon neighborhood of L. The precise let me see, yes, we just give a definition, right? And for the limit at infinity, we look at the right side is a positive infinity. We look at the left side is a negative infinity. Okay, we have intuitive definition. Most important, we have what? We have a precise definition. Someone you can say like epsilon n language. Okay, well, I give epsilon, you find n. No matter is a positive infinity. If I look at the positive infinity, n is a positive number. If I look at the left negative infinity, n is a negative number. But we still can say it's just an epsilon n language. Okay, whatever. Here we give the name is precise. Now, we use the precise definition. Going to prove this is true. This is important because later we have a result. It's not in this video. The next video we have another result. Okay, based the results were based on these small results. Okay, and the DAO results were very important for calculation to find the limit at infinity. So can we look at these results? 1 out of x, which is reciprocal. Of course, this is super easy, right? What this is 1 if we direct this up to the I guess it goes to infinity, so 1 out of infinity, imagine, the bottom goes to infinity, so 1 out of infinity goes to 0. That should be, right? Should it be, but how to say, okay, in strict language, in strict mathematical language, that's the precise definition. Let me show you something. I only have this example, okay, so to show how is the precise definition to choose to find the limit at infinity. Do you remember how to prove this? All we need to do is do this, right? Given epsilon greater than 0, no matter how small, we need to find the n. Of course, this n is large enough. This is n should be, this time I look at it, the positive infinity, should it be n is greater than 0, you know? Okay, in these cases, n is greater than 0. We need to find the n. When x is greater than n, see, which means x is large enough. And then, f going to the epsilon neighborhood of L. Do you remember the similar for epsilon delta definition? So how do you do? Find this, that's the most important, right? But how do you find this? We need to explore this inequality, right? We need to do this. Okay, from here to find the n. If you find it and this statement is true, that's a proof. How do you do this? Let me explore this one. What does this mean? We need to solve this inequality. What is f minus l? Let me see. F, I guess in our example is 1 out of x, so which means 1 out of x. And the L in our example is 0, right? Okay, so this means this is less than epsilon. Let me see, that's less than epsilon. Okay, we need to find the n. We need to do one more time. And this means what? Let me directly just look at the left. We'll just look at the left. The left is just 1 out of x, right? Why? Because x is greater than n, which means x is positive, definitely. Because x should be equal to positive infinity. So x is positive. We can ignore the epsilon value. And this is less than epsilon. We can go from here, okay? X greater than n, 1 out of x should be less than 1 out of n. See, this is a control. And then we can do this. We can set up this equals epsilon. Okay? We just set up this equation. If this equation we can solve for n. Why? Okay, because 1 out of x less than this, so 1 out of x less than epsilon, this is true, right? Okay, let me solve this equation. So after we solve, what do we get? We get n equals 1 out of epsilon. So this is the one we need. Easily, okay? We already find the n. If x greater than n, definitely this is true, right? Okay, therefore, we find it. So this is explore. We find the n. Good. Let me write down the step. What do we have? All we need to do is just write down what we find. Okay. So is this given epsilon, right? All we need to do is just give epsilon any. greater than 0. And have we choose n? Yes. Our going to choose m is 1 out of optional. Is 1 out of optional. Why? Because we just find it. Now, can we going to see the statement is true? If x is larger than n, if f going to the epsilon neighborhood of L, that's true. If x greater than n, then can we see, is this true? I just direct the rule, what we just get. We get what? 1 out of x, this is f, minus L is 0. Absolute value. Do you remember how did we get it? It's 1 out of x, right? And we say when x is greater than n, this is less than 1 out of n. And n we set up that. Let me plug in 1 out of 1 out of epsilon. What do we get? Is epsilon. Can you see? If x is greater than n, okay, so alpha, the distance between f and l is less than epsilon. That's what? This is the precise definition. If this statement is true by the precise definition, so we have these results. And so by the precise definition, right? The precise definition, if you forget it, you go back to check. Okay, give any optional, if x is large enough and the distance is small enough, that which means we have this limit. Okay, the limit x approaches infinity, 1 out of x is 0. That's the proof, exactly proof. Okay, and let me go into find the limits using table. Do you remember? We know how to prove, does not mean that we know how to find, okay? And the first method, the very original method, is just look at the pattern from the value of the function, okay? If the value of the function is approached to a number, then that number we should be the limit. And where to find the pattern? From the table list, okay? So we're going to list all the value of the function. And by taking x gets bigger and bigger and bigger, and then we can look at the pattern to find the limit at infinity, as we did before, okay? As we did before for normal limit. For example, here. This is the example. What do we have? We have a function. And this function is ln over x, lnx over x. We look at the limit as x approaches infinity, what is, okay, the limit of this function. Of course, in the future, you will learn that we directly find, okay, by ourselves. But now we don't know what are we going to do. We set up f is this function, and then to list all the value of the function at x equals 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, 100,000, which means what? We by taking x gets bigger and bigger, and look at the pattern of the value of the function. Okay, so all we need to do is just list all the value. When x equals 1, f equals 0. When x equals 10, f equals this. When x equals 100, this, 1000, this. Can we see the pattern? Okay. And from zero, no matter, 0 does not matter. So from 2.3, 0.006, this is scientific notation. This means, which means 9.2 times 10 raised to the negative 4th power. If we change to decimal, it's 0.00092. Okay, this is 0.000, three zeros, okay, after the decimal, 1, 2. What does it mean? If we list again, this should be get smaller and smaller and smaller, goes to 0. Therefore, what? Okay, so by the pattern. So therefore, we can say this. We can say by the pattern directly. By the pattern, or the pattern shows. Let me see. By the pattern. Okay, we have this. We have the limit is 0 because this is approaching 0, right? So we have the limit as x approaches infinity because we take x gets bigger and bigger and bigger, fx okay equals 0. This f of course is that. And did the questions? Of course. And we have a simple way. Do you remember? We have a simple way by using the graph calculator, define f, and then using the table and the directly list all these values directly. I should allow our time, so I'm going to show one more time. Let me see. Let me set up my calculator. Let me turn on the calculator. So here is my calculator. What do we need to do? Okay, how to directly find this in the calculator? Define f and then type all the x into AL1, the table, and then apply the function to AL1. We put this into AL2. Okay, that's all. Then we're going to define the function is y equals. Okay, already defined this is the function. That the first step, let me do first. Yeah, already define the function. The second step we're going to find that the stat. Okay, so click the stat. Okay, edit, click and good. Type all the x value on L1. See, the x value from 1, 10, all this put to L1. Already type. Already define the function. Already type this. Now I'm going to use the function, and put all the value of the function to L2, the second color. How do you do? Go to the top of AR2. They're going to find that the value of the function, which is go to varus, go to write y varus function, just end. See, y1 is where we defined. Okay, y1 apply to AR1, put the parenthesis, and the AR1 is the second one, and another parenthesis, and then end. See, that's all the value. This value is exactly the same value we just see. Okay. Let me see. We go back to the question. And we just have this. And we just, I just showed you how to use the calculator directly to get this as quick as you can. And by the pattern, we know the limit is 0. And in the future, we can find it by ourselves, not by the calculator, okay? And one more questions. I'm going to shoot the second. This is a famous function. And this function, this limit is linked to the exponential function, e raised to the x power, okay? In the future, I will introduce. But here, so we're going to find that the limit at infinity, at a negative infinity, right? Okay, at a negative infinity, no matter it's negative or positive, all we need to do is put at the table. Okay, going to look at the pattern from the table. The value of the f is this. Okay, of course, f is this function. And then we pick x is negative 1, negative 10, negative 100, negative 1000, negative 10,000, negative 100,000. You see, x gets bigger. At a bigger, of course, is in the direction of negative. We suggest x gets bigger negative, okay? So we put the order x value, define the function in the calculator, apply the function as we just did, and this is the value we get. What the pattern tell us? The pattern tell us 1.3553, can you see this? At least the first three decimal is already fixed. Which means what? If we count the approximator, we say the limit of going to 0.1353. Okay, going to this. You can see these three are fixed. And the three. If you look at a little bit one more, so probably the fifth digit is also fixed. Okay, whatever. So from the pattern. So here, what do we say? So by the pattern. Okay, so we can guess, this is not a proof, this is just a guess, okay. We can guess the limit at a negative infinity, the value, I just use f, okay, this f equals, I cannot say equal, probably to this approximate, right, because it's round as a 0.1353. Okay, so this is what we get from the calculator. I said that this is really important in the future. So what the exact, okay, in the future you will know the exact is this. The exact, this is approach e raised to the negative 2th power. Someone you can go and check. E raised to the negative 2th power is around this. That's the exact value from the calculation. This is exact. And you have to wait a little. Okay, in the future, I'm going to introduce this to you. That's all. Thank you.